Good morning all of you. Today we will continue with the chapter. This is chapter number 2 and the name of the chapter is January Night. As you know, in this chapter we have discussed about the character Halku. Halku was a farmer. He was doing a tenant farming, and in a tenant farming a person take land from another person and do the farming, and in return he have to give some amount of money. So he was asking for 3 rupees from his wife, and then afterwards he has given that amount of money to the landlord. But he was very sad because he wanted to purchase a blanket from that amount of money. So now he was in the field and continuously cold wind was blowing. It was tormenting him. He was having a dog whose name was Jabra. He was having a very good bond and very good friendship with his dog Jabra. So cold weather was continuously tormenting him. So he decided that he will burn fire from the leaves, and he went to orchard, and then after going there he has burned some leaves so that he and Jabra can feel the warmth of the fire and can live properly in that night. Okay, so from now we will continue. The leaves were all burned up. Darkness covered the orchard again. Under the ashes a few embers smoldered, and when a gust of wind blew over them they stirred up briefly, then flickered out again. Halku sat up by the warm ashes, humming a tune. The fire had warmed him though, but as the cold began to spread, he felt drowsy. Now all the leaves which he has collected, all the leaves were burning. Okay? Now darkness covered the orchard again, and there was darkness in the orchard. Bagiche mein bahut zyada darkness thi, and ashes few embers smoldered. मीन्स जो एसेस थी, मीन्स जो लीव्स की जो एस बची हुई थी, उससे उसका जो धुआं उठ रहा था वो ऐसा था कि वो स्मल्डर्ड हो रहा था, मीन्स जो कि सांस घोटने वाला था. एंड व्हेन अ गस्ट ऑफ विंड ब्लू ओवर देम दे स्टर्ड अप ब्रीफली, एंड कंटिन्यूअसली जो हवाएं होती हैं, जो विंड होती है, इट वॉज कंटिन्यूअसली ब्लोइंग. हल्कू सेट बाय द वॉर्म एसेस. सो हल्कू वॉज सिटिंग नियर द फायर एंड ही वॉज हमिंग अ ट्यून. ही वॉज सिंगिंग अ सॉन्ग. द फायर हैड वॉर्म्ड हिम थॉ, and fire has given him enough warmth, and now he was feeling little drowsy. He was feeling little sleepy. He want to sleep. Okay, now Jabra gave a loud bark and ran towards the field. Halku realized that this meant a pack of wild animal had probably broken into the field. They might be bluebuck, they must be grazing. He began to hear the sound of nibbling. So now what happened, Jabra was continuously barking. ओके, जबरा बहुत तेज तेज बाग कर रहा था. एंड रन टूवर्ड्स द फील्ड, और फील्ड की तरफ दौड़ा. हल्को रियलाइज दैट दिस मैंड अ पैक ऑफ वाइल्ड एनिमल. उसको पता चल गया कि वाइल्ड एनिमल्स आ रहे हैं. दे हैव ब्रोकन इन टू द फील्ड. वो फील्ड में आ चुके हैं, एंड दे माइट बी ब्लू बैक. हो सकता है वो ब्लू बक हो. दे मस्ट बी ग्रेजिंग. वो क्या कर रहे थे, ग्रेस कर रहे थे, चर रहे थे. एंड ही बिगिन टू हियर द साउंड ऑफ निबलिंग, मीन्स ही वॉज फीलिंग द साउंड दैट दे वर ईटिंग द फॉरेस्ट, और यू कैन से दे वर ईटिंग द एग्रीकल्चर फील्ड. ओके, नाउ ही थॉट नो, विद जबरा अराउंड नो एनिमल कैन गेट इन टू द फील्ड. ही वुड रिप इट टू स्ट्रेट्स. आई मस्ट हैव बीन मिस्टेकन. नाउ देयर इज नो साउंड एट ऑल. नाउ ही वॉज थिंकिंग, वेन जबरा इज हेयर, माई डॉग इज हेयर, सो हाउ कैन इवन एनी एनिमल एंटर टू माई फील्ड. Jabra is enough to deal with all this, right? No animal can enter into my field until and unless I am having my dog Jabra. Okay? I must have been mistaken. मैंने जरूर गलती करी होगी. ऐसा हो ही नहीं सकता कि कोई भी एनिमल यहाँ मेरी फील्ड में आ सके जब तक Jabra यहाँ पे है. He shouted, Jabra, Jabra. Jabra went on barking and did not come to him. Jabra, Jabra, he was shouting, but Jabra was continuously barking. वो भौंक रहा था and did not come to him, और उसके पास नहीं आया. Then again there was a sound of munching and crunching in the field. He could not have been mistaken this time. Now again he was hearing a sound that munching and crunching in the field means कुछ जैसे कोई खा रहा हो चल रहा हो. He could not have been mistaken this time. इस बार उसने गलती नहीं करी थी सुनने में. It really hurt to think of getting up from where he was. It was so comfortable there. It seemed intolerable to go to the field in this cold and chase after animal he didn't stir. Now it was very very difficult for Jabra to move from the place from where he was sleeping because it was very cold at that time and it was intolerable. ये मतलब संभव ही नहीं था कि वो वहां से उठे और वहां से उठ के जाए एनिमल्स को चेस करे उन्हें भगाए. सो इट वॉज वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर हिम टू वेक अप एंड टू गो एंड टू चेस द एनिमल्स. ही शाउटेड हिल्लो हिल्लो हिल्लो. जबरा स्टार्टेड बार्किंग अगेन. There were animals eating his field just when the crop was ready. Means crop was almost ready and the animals were eating the entire field. What a fine crop it was and these cursed animals were destroying it. Now what a fine crop. Kitni achhi crop hai lekin ye sare animals kya kar rahe hain usko destroy kar rahe hain kharab kar rahe hain. With a firm resolve he got up and took a few steps but suddenly a gust of wind pierced him with a sting like a scorpion such that he went back. Now with a firm resolve ab usne ekdam tay kar liya means he has taken the decision that he will go and he will chase the animal. Usne tay kar liya ki wo jayega aur animals ko bhagayega. But suddenly a gust of wind pierced him. Lekin suddenly ek bahut tezi se hawa ka jhonka aaya aur usko pierce kar diya jaise usko like with a sting jaise usko koi dunk maar diya jaise ki scorpion hota hai jaise bichhu hota hai usko dunk maar diya koi jaise us tarah ka hawa ka jhonka aaya. He went back and sat again by the sting using fire. Wo wapas wahan pe chala gaya aur fir se wahi jo aag bujh chuki thi usi ke paas jaake baith gaya. And stirred up the ashes to warm his chilled body. And fir se wo apne ashes ke paas wahi baith gaya taki wo apni body ko kya kar sake warm kar sake apni chilled body ko. Now Halku went on sitting peacefully near the warm ashes. His doziness held him motionless as though with ropes. Wrapped in his shawl, he fell asleep on the warm ground near the ashes. As you know, Halku was sleeping peacefully. He was in a very peaceful manner and he was sitting near the warm ashes. Means warm ashes ke paas baitha hua tha, aag jahan ekdam bujh chuki thi, ashes the, dhuaan tha uska. His drowsiness held him motionless. Lekin wo itna zyada drowsy feel kar raha tha, sleepy feel kar raha tha ki uski wajah se wo motionless ho gaya tha, koi movement nahi kar pa raha tha. As though with ropes, jaise usko kisi ne rope se baandh diya ho. Rope matlab jante hai na aap log, rope means rassi. Wrapped in his shawl, he fell asleep. Apni shawl mein wo wrapped tha, he was wrapped in his shawl and he fell asleep. Neend mein ho gaya wo. On the warm ground near the ashes, उस ground पे जो कि warm हो चुकी थी ashes से. When he woke up in the morning, the sun was high and Munni was saying, "Do you think you are going to sleep all day? You come out here and had a fine time while the whole field was being flattened." Now when he woke up in the morning, morning में जब वो उठा, so now Munni was saying, she was shouting that, "Do you think you are going to sleep all day? तुम्हें लगता है तुम पूरे दिन सोना चाहते हो? You came out here, तुम यहाँ पे आए and you were having a fine time, बहुत अच्छा समय बिताया तुमने. And what happened? The whole field was flattened. पूरे field को क्या कर दिया गया? Flatten कर दिया गया, उसको graze कर दिया गया, सारे animals ने उसको क्या कर रहा? चर लिया, है ना? So now you will do the question answer. This is question number G. H से हम लोग करेंगे. Okay? Why did Jabra probably think he was in heaven? So Jabra probably thought he was in heaven because his master held him on his lap and hugged him. The dog felt warm and comfortable. As you know that the dog name is what? Jabra. And he was feeling like heaven. Why he was feeling like heaven? Because his owner Halku has hugged him tightly and since he has hugged him tightly he was feeling the warmth of the human body and he was feeling very comfortable in that cold night. Okay, why did Halku look up at the sky? Halku was looking to the sky, but why Halku looked up the sky? To see how far the stars had moved and how much of night was left. ही वॉज थिंकिंग दैट हाउ फार हैज स्टार्स मूव, कितनी स्टार्स अभी कितना मूव कर चुके हैं और अभी कितनी रात बाकी है, हाउ मच नाइट इज स्टिल टू बी देयर. ओके, नाउ दिस इज रेफरेंस टू कॉन्टेक्स्ट. टेल हिम वी विल पे हिम आफ्टर द हार्वेस्ट, नॉट राइट नाउ. So this is the line which was said by whom? Who is speaking and to whom? So as you all know that Munni was speaking, wife of Halku was speaking. To whom she was speaking? She was saying this to Halku. Who is the him the speaker refers to? The landlord is referred to as him. Landlord ko kya bola gaya hai? Him. Okay, what is the payment the speaker refers to? Okay, the payment is the rent for the land. Okay, now he has to give some payment now to the whom? To the landlord. Because he was working in the field of the landlord. So in return, he have to give some amount of money to the landlord as a rent. So the payment which the speaker is talking about is what? Is talking about the payment or the rent for the land. Okay, so as you all know, till now we have understand that Halku was a farmer. He was doing a tenant farming and he have given 3 rupees also to the landlord. But in the cold night, cold winds were tormenting him. Okay, he was having a dog also. Since the night was very cold, he hugged his dog. And after that, when it was intolerable, then he burned some fire, okay, from the leaves. And he was getting warm from the fire and he was sitting near the fire. Okay, but after some time Halku heard the grazing sound of some animals and his dog Jabra was continuously barking to the animal. Okay, but Halku was feeling drowsy, he was feeling very very sleepy, so he was incapable to wake up and to go there to chase the animal. So he was sitting near the burned ashes and after that he was feeling very sleepy. And when in the morning he waked up, he realized that all the field was grazed, all the field was flattened. Okay, hope you have understand the lesson properly. Thank you.